Inpainting within ComfyUI is a fairly straightforward process. So to get started, I went ahead and loaded up an inpainting checkpoint. So this is very important because inpainting checkpoints are trained on partial images. So this will give you much better results than using a generation model. So I'm going to go ahead and just load an image that I already have on my computer here. And so basically what I want to do is I want to make this person wearing glasses. So I'm going to go ahead and open in masked editor to basically tell the inpainting model where I want to only make the changes. So since we're going to be doing glasses, I'm just going to mask out this part of their face. And for the image output, we're going to connect it to this VAE encode for inpaint. And this is very important here. So we'll go ahead and pass along not only the image, but also the mask as well, this area that we just highlighted. And then for the VAE, we can use it from this inpainting model or use a separate VAE if necessary. So we'll go ahead and connect this to the K-sampler node. And I'm going to go ahead and set my prompt. So I have a photo of a woman wearing glasses in best quality for my positive prompt. And for my negative prompt, I'm going to use a couple of embeddings that are suggested to be used with this inpainting model. For the seed, you can make this random. I'm going to go ahead and make it fixed just for testing here. And then I'm going to go ahead and change the sampler to the one that works best for this checkpoint. Again, you'll want to go ahead and set it to whatever is recommended by the author of the checkpoint that you're using. And so then I'm going to go ahead and just preview the output and then simply hit cue prompt. Okay, so here's our output. We now can see that our subject is wearing glasses, which is really great. But one of the problems with this entire process, especially when working with larger images, is it can be a little lengthy. So if you want to make them on smaller images, say if you have a larger input image and you want to make it a little bit smaller so it's a little bit more efficient with the model, that's fairly easy to do. So you're just going to go ahead and click on this add node and then click on image and then click image resize. So we're just going to basically pass this image along with the mask into this image resize node and then connect it into this VAE encode along with the mask. And then we're going to go ahead and say what we want to resize it by. So this image was originally roughly about 1,000 pixels wide by 1,300 pixels tall. So to work with a diffusion model, we would need at least a 512 image. So I'm going to go ahead and just set the smaller size to 512. And then go ahead and cue the prompt, and we can see that it goes through much quicker than what it did previously, and it still provided good results. However, though, this output image is now at a much smaller size, but can definitely work in a use case if you find that the inpainting process is kind of slow. So that's it with inpainting with ComfyUI. I hope that you found this video helpful. If you have any questions on the workflow here, please feel free to leave a question in the comments below. Thanks so much for watching, and take care.